Did you play sports when you were younger or no?
Oh yeah, I played a lot of sport. I played like every sport basically.
Really? What was your best sport?
Either football or soccer. I'm not
Ooh.
100% sure, but
What position did you play in football?
in football, I played quarterback, but of course I didn't play in high school, so that's kind of a little bit of a whatever. I played in flag football up until I was
Oh, flag football's
like
sick.
16 or something, I don't know.
I like flag football. I used to play
Well,
that a
to
lot.
be fair, I played flag football when I was in high school. But I didn't play high school football. But it was only the only reason I didn't was I actually well, I was on the team, but then I went into online school. So I played flag football when I was in online school, and I was quarterback.
Why did you choose
I
to
played
go
soccer
on?
for a long period of time, and I was goalie in soccer. So.
Why did you decide? Like, can you give out the information on like why you chose online school?
Yeah. So I was very like I obviously I'm like. I love computers and technology and stuff.
Never would
And
have guessed.
my school didn't offer any tech. Like the only technology course they offered was Microsoft Word, and like I was already like certified in Microsoft Word and Office and Excel and stuff. And so it was like I wanted to take computer classes, but there was no computer classes. And so I really wanted to be able to take online classes in order to do that. And also I really struggled like waking up at 5 a.m. in the morning and walking and crap. I think it's something where I would have I don't know. So I ended up going into online school and I took a bunch of like tech courses, like a lot of tech courses. That's how I actually learned a lot about computers and hardware and networking and software. And I probably wouldn't be where I am honestly with
True. That was
but there's a long story to kind of how it happened. Like I was like my parents didn't want to put me into online school, and I wanted to go into online school.
Well, the upside to actually doing like there's upsides to both doing online school and IRL
I
school. I
can't
think the
believe you've
big
done
thing
this.
for going to high school like as a human being, like normally, would be the fact that you get more social interaction.
I feel like I was such a social kid, like because I don't know, I did like I said, I did like everything. Like I was in like clubs and I don't know. Like I did like literally everything. So I was always talking with people and I always had like my best friends like all lived like the houses all around me and stuff. I had like five really good friends that all lived like next door and next door to them and next door to them and stuff.
I've never really heard or like talked to someone that was like open about online school. Like, was that like good for like your, let's say like your mental health, like being home all the time? What did that feel like?
I mean, to me, it was great, but it's because I would just like cheat and then I would go play Minecraft. I mean, I'm just being honest. I'm just being completely honest. I mean, that's literally. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna sit here and be like, oh, well, yeah, I did my work and it was poggers and,
Dream. If any of you guys in the chat end up dropping out and going to
Oh,
online
yeah.
school, please tell me because that's actually
Amazing school.
hilarious.
Yeah.
So wait, how would you
No,
cheat?
I mean, you just look up the answers because, like, you
It's
just.
really that easy?
Well, the only thing, like, there's certain things you couldn't cheat on. Like, I failed Spanish because, like, I can't cheat Spanish. Like, I just didn't know Spanish and I'm too
Google
lazy to learn
Translate
it.
didn't work?
Well, like, no, because they'd, like, you have to, like, call and do these, like calls with a teacher or whatever where they actually quiz you, like, live so you can't, like, cheat. And I mean, I am genuinely smart, so I can learn things really quickly. So I would just cram before these calls. Like, you can't just cram Spanish. Like, I'm gonna learn Spanish in 10 minutes. Like, you can't do that. But like with other subjects, you can. The only one that I didn't ever cheat on was English. And that English, but I did. I ended up graduating. What's funny thing is, I ended up. I missed like, I think like 6 months of school or something because of like all the skipping. That sounds really bad, but I mean it was bad. But anyway, but I ended up graduating early because I did like all my classes like early, and one of them was English. Like, and I literally would just go through and I would just like write these essays and stuff. Like, I mean, very quickly. And English was the only subject I didn't cheat in. So I did cheat in like every other subject though. I'm like math sucked because math was hard to cheat in because it's math.
So far, you
And
have
I'm not
been.
encouraging cheating. I'm just being open about my experience. I'm just saying, yes, I did bad things as a kid and I did stupid things, and I regret a lot of it. I don't regret other things, but I feel like I wouldn't necessarily be where I am if I wasn't who I am.
I was gonna say, you've been such a good influence up to this point. I think I asked the wrong question.
Well, it's because you're asking about my past self. You're not asking about me now.
Oh, my mistake. But do you remember any words in Spanish other than the very basic ones? Can you formulate a sentence for me?
Oh, I mean, I can say like,
No swears.
I mean, I can say like very, I can say like very basic, like very, very basic. Like, I don't know. See, I know, like, I can probably ask like what your name is, and I can probably ask like where you're from. I could probably say like I think I know like milk. Like, isn't milk like crap? I don't know. Wait, cat. Cat's like a gato, right? Is a cat?
I never took Spanish.
Okay.
Like, so
leche. Leche's milk. Yeah, gato, that's speed cat, running right? Because he has this cat singing on you.
Speed running
but
the
I, test. I know very basic, like very, very basic. But I also took French. I took 2 years of French, right? And
okay.
That was in middle school. And in middle school, I took 2 years of French. And in French class, because we used Rosetta Stone, I was
really?
In, yeah. And it was on the computer. And I would go in, and instead of going in Rosetta Stone, I would open up a Notepad and start HTML coding websites. I spent like, I'm not even kidding, I coded a bunch of websites, and I spent like 90% of my time in my French class just coding websites in Notepad.
You were able to code a website in grade school, middle school?
Well, I mean, Notepad, yeah. Notepad, that wasn't Java. Like, I didn't learn Java until much later. But like HTML is like, I'm telling you can probably learn a lot of HTML in one. I used to teach like HTML to my friends. HTML is very easy, but like, I mean, I don't understand why it could be difficult for some people, but I feel like I genuinely believe that some people's brains are just wired differently to like learning code. Like,
fair.
Yeah, no, I feel like it takes a very particular like problem solving and stuff. Like, I don't know. I feel like the same way with like language. Like, I feel like I just couldn't learn a language even if I tried.
Yeah, I
tried. And I feel like certain people are like that as well. I think it's the same. It's like the same with like coding usually. But yeah, HTML is super easy. I have ADHD, so in school, like, I mean, I don't know a single class that I could ever. Like, I feel like if I showed you my notepads, like, you'd think I'm a crackhead. Like, actually, I'm telling you, I have notepads from back when I was in like high school and middle school that like I'm like drawing like games like that I'm trying like I oh I can like I'm not obviously I wasn't a capable developer back then. Like, I would be like drawing like pages of games and stuff, like, and like scribbles of like just random like people and stuff, and like art and like just, and then just writing random stories that I just would like throw away the next day and stuff, like, and or like as in not actually literally throw away, but like throw away as in never like write it again. And like I guarantee you in all of my schooling years after like elementary, I spent way more time like fidgeting and doodling and stuff than I spent learning. Like, I 100%, like, at least
I
at
love
least
that I love that's a thing. But you said you had the notepads. Do you still have them? Can you send
me
a picture?
I have them. I don't have them right now next to me, but I do have them. And I think I probably still have it somewhere. I had one where I was like writing like Minecraft diss track. I'm not even kidding. Like, at the back of these notebooks, I remember I went through this like last year or something, and I was reading these notebooks. Like, at the back of like this notebook, I had like it was like mobs going. That's so cringy. Like,
please.
It was, like, mobs like rap battling each other or something.
Dude, that has to be. Please, 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 please do that and upload it to like DreamXD. That would be hilarious. Now, when did you say you wrote this? Like, how young were you?
I was in middle school, so I was probably
maybe middle school, maybe last week. I don't really.
I think I was probably like 14 or 13.
Dude, you're so young.
Yeah, I mean, I met Sapnap when he was, I think, 10, maybe 11.
Really? Wait, you guys met by like what was the server? It was bad server, wasn't it?
It was it wasn't his server, but yeah, he was admin on it. It was MCPUP. Yeah, I think we met. He might have been 11. He might have been 11.
That makes a huge difference. I'm glad you clarified that.
I'm pretty sure I was 13 and he was 11.
Aww.